Good evening, and thank you so much for joining me again today with my concert series From My Home to Your Home. And for the new audience, welcome. Muchas gracias por acompañarme nuevamente en el día de hoy con mi serie de conciertos de mi casa a sus hogares. Para la nueva audiencia, bienvenidos. I felt very moved to have this live video show in this particular month of March. Not only was it heartfelt, but it is very important for many reasons. This month of March is the remembrance of the lives lost to the current pandemic. And I am dedicating this concert to all those dear people and their families. On a positive note, now the vaccines are finally available and we have now a great hope all over the world. Today, March 12th, is the 100th anniversary birth date of one of the composers of the evening, the famous Argentinian composer, Astor Piazzolla, from the 20th century. Last week was the anniversary birthday of another composer, very famous, Frédéric Chopin. By coincidence, they are the first and last composers from my latest CD, Bridges from Chopin to Piazzolla. And now, last but not least, March is Women's History Month. And I am honoring all the women who follow and fought for their dreams, their rights, and their ideas to make a real difference in the world. But also, I am honoring all the women who contributed in some ways, but were not noticed or recognized. What you should know about this concert is that it was very important in my career since I made the decision to promote all the great classical Latin American composers. This hall, as you will see, has a very unique concert stage. Not only has three-story high windows in the background, but also you can see Central Park and later on the sunset. Of course, I was very nervous about being distracted by them, but when I started performing, as always, the magic came and I was in my own world of musical heaven with the audience. Lincoln Center had two big posters for a long time to promote the concert. And I have here one of the original ones to show you. The concert is 40 minutes 15 seconds long. I'm performing one prelude by La Sala, two preludes by Guastavino, two Argentinian dances by Ginastera, and four tangos by Piazzolla. In the performance, I speak about 1 minute before each composer to explain details about the music. I will be here watching the video with you, the concert, and I will wait for you until the end to share some feelings and say goodbye. Estuve muy conmovida preparando este evento en este mes tan especial, marzo. Es el recuerdo de las vidas perdidas en la pandemia comenzando marzo en el 2020. Hoy, marzo 2021, tenemos una gran esperanza, luz, al tener las vacunas accesibles. Hoy, marzo 12, es el cumpleaños, el aniversario de 100 años del nacimiento del compositor famoso Astor Piazzolla. La semana pasada fue el aniversario de Frédéric Chopin, los dos compositores, primero y último de mi CD, Puentes de Chopin a Piazzolla. También marzo es el mes de la mujer y estoy haciendo honor a todas las mujeres que lucharon por sus derechos, por sus sueños y por sus ideales. Y también por aquellas mujeres que contribuyeron en diferentes maneras, pero no fueron reconocidas. Este concierto es muy importante para mí, ya que noté lo que significa la promoción de los compositores clásicos latinoamericanos. El concierto es 40 minutos, 15 segundos, y toco obras de La Sala, un preludio, dos preludios de Guastavino, dos argentinas danzas de Ginastera y cuatro tangos de Piazzolla. Al comienzo de cada compositor, en el concierto, explico por un minuto acerca de la música. Voy a estar mirando el concierto con ustedes, compartiéndolo, y los espero al final para despedirnos y compartir algunos sentimientos. Espero que lo disfruten.
Welcome to all of you. Bienvenidos. Tonight I'm going to play pieces which are dear to my heart, and I'm going to tell you some personal connections I had with the composers I'm going to perform and with their music. For example, the first composer, Ángel La Sala, he was my teacher at the National Conservatory of Music, and one day he sat me down and he said, Rosa, I'm going to give you this piece, and I love if one day you introduce it to the world. And his wife, Zuleba, told me that he wrote this piece from his heart to inspire love. And the title of the piece he gave me in the actual manuscript is Romancero. It's a prelude and means describes a person who is in a state of love or romance all the time. Thank you. Carlos Guastavino, the next composer, was also my teacher at the National Conservatory of Music. And what I admired in this composer is that he was inspired by the human voice, like Chopin. And I grew up listening to my mother's voice because she was an opera singer. Then when I am playing his music, I feel like I am singing it from my heart. And these two preludes describe Guastavino's feelings when he came back to visit his parents' home, that which was abandoned at that time, and reminds me the memories I have in the backyard with my mother, who was my mentor, my support, and my angel. And then, and his favorite tree, the weeping willow tree, which is the sauce, the prelude, it was the same I had in our backyard. Then for you, these two preludes.
Thank you.
my next composer is one of my favorite Argentinian composer, Alberto Ginastera. And he was the first Argentinian composer I learned when I was at the conservatory. And by that time, I was learning how to dance folklore. And I fell in love so much with these pieces, with these danzas, the Argentinian dances, that I asked my teacher if we can make a choreography with those pieces. And it was an absolutely beautiful experience. And the way he describes the pampas and the characters of the pampas is something that really touched my heart. And in the La Moza de Donosa, the way he describes this person, this woman who is waiting for the gaucho in the pampas, never knowing if he was going to come back or not.
Thank you.
The other special thing tonight about Ginastera is I am honored that his daughter, Georgina Ginastera, is here with us. About the tangos, I have to say that now I love tangos, but when I was a child, I didn't feel to play the tangos, and I never knew it why. Until one day I met Piazzolla, and we were talking about the history of the tango, and I realized that besides the passion and the drama that the tango carries, there is the melancholy. And I grew up in a family, we came back from Italy, all my family came back from Italy to Argentina, and they had the hope, but they had a melancholy leaving all the friends and families there. And then when I realized what the resistance I had, it was about, it was when I could get the freedom to express my feelings and perform the tangos with all those expression I can do. Tangos tonight you have in the program Rio Sena, who won the award in Paris. Thank you. next Milonga del Ángel, I like to say that Piazzolla felt that there was an angel who came in the Christmas time when people from Argentina were more sad because being far from their family, and he named the Milonga del Ángel, feeling there was an angel who came to heal the souls of people in Argentina.
Thank you.
enjoy this concert as much as I did sharing it with you. You could see the difference in the light from the beginning till the sunset. Thank you so much for being with me tonight. I hope you can be with me again March 31st. And it will be the second part of this concert. Have a great night. Until then. Espero hayan disfrutado de este concierto como lo hice yo compartiéndolo con ustedes. Pudieron ver la diferencia de la luz desde el comienzo hasta el atardecer. Gracias nuevamente y espero verlos el 31 de marzo para compartir la segunda parte de este concierto. Buenas noches y hasta pronto.